What should be taking place in Zimbabwe's natural resources sector to revive the natural resources sector?
Yeah, so in response to that question, we have to take into consideration that mining is not a new industry to Zimbabwe. So when you're looking at what sort of support can be given to the mining sector there, there's short-term and then there's long-term interventions. I would rather the focus be on the longer term interventions, because of the short term interventions, these are sometimes solutions that will not necessarily fix the problem and will recur again. So looking at the long term solutions, I think there's quite a lot of work to be done on the legal, on the regulatory and on the policy side to put in place good framework for developing the mining sector within the long term. So usually when people talk about these sorts of reforms, most common response is it's as good as your implementation capacity. So you can have a fantastic mining code, you can have best in class or best practice legal regulatory regime and policies, but at the end of the day, do you have the capacity to be able to implement that? So I would focus more on institutional strengthening to make sure that these reforms actually make sense. So a very good place to start, considering how long mining has been existing in Zimbabwe, is just looking at our ability to attract more exploration spend. That is where the focus should be for Zimbabwe. But before we even run out and start saying to investors, come to Zimbabwe and invest in greenfield or brownfield projects, we should look at how much does Zimbabwe actually know about the quality and the quantity of its natural resources. So I would say in terms of the long-term interventions, the focus should be on geodata and understanding what the country has.
What is the most pressing challenge currently facing Zimbabwe's natural resources sector? And do you perhaps have any suggestions on ways to mitigate this in the meanwhile?
So the challenges facing the resource sector, I think we have to look at the way the mining sector within the country is dualized between the artisanal and small-scale mining sector and also the large-scale mines. So each of them have their very own unique challenges. But the ultimate thing is the ability to be able to meet your regular operating costs, to be able to fund your capital expenditure, and also have enough left to invest in growth programs or expansion for your operation. That's something that is cross-cutting across all of those miners. So to enable that to happen, it's having a fiscal regime that allows the mining companies to get the best that they can from their production and their exports. So that goes down to how is the foreign exchange regime in the country working. So there needs to be clarity pretty quickly in terms of how that's going to work, because there's a discussion of a new currency being introduced. So of course, for even the small scale miners, they all think to themselves, if there's a new currency that's going to be introduced, how about this existing bond currency in the country? How much will that be worth once the new currency is introduced? So therefore, if I'm going to be selling my output and I'm going to get paid for it in local currency, what will that local currency mean for me when it's changed? So two things will either happen. Number one is either they will produce and stockpile for the larger scale miners, or the smaller scale ones, they will start finding alternative ways to smuggle their output out of the country so that they can realize a gain in another currency which has more stability. Okay. So that's the most pressing challenge, foreign currency.
Okay. What advice would you give to companies currently operating in Zimbabwe and possibly companies looking to do business in Zimbabwe's natural resources sector on how to overcome some of the economic challenges present in the country?
So for companies operating in Zimbabwe, the fact that they've been there and they're continuing to exist there, I'm sure they have their own methods in terms of how to engage. But the most important thing in Zimbabwe is realizing that within the Ministry of Mines, there is a desire to understand better the challenges that existing miners are facing. So one of the most important things is when you have your disputes, and most of the mining companies operating in the country realize this, when you have your disputes, is it about megaphone diplomacy or is it about closed door constructive engagement? And the experience of the mining companies that have been operating in Zimbabwe would suggest the latter, which is part of the reason why they're still operating there. But we cannot discount the fact that sometimes even closed door dialogue does not give you the answers that you want. But the most important thing is to realize that should be your starting point of engagement. There are a lot of industry bodies that exist within the country representing both the ASM, which is artisanal and small scale miners, and the large scale miners. And those are pretty effective bodies for engagement. And pretty much most players within the industry utilize those. The focus should rather be on those who are looking at Zimbabwe as a new investment destination, either looking at joint venture partnerships with companies that are already operating there or looking to start up new operations. Those are the ones who need the most guidance, because Zimbabwe's resource endowment is pretty well known. Zimbabwe's mining history is pretty well known. But then there is also the political economy, which becomes this amorphous, unnavigable beast to a lot of companies looking into the country. First thing is first for companies that want to invest there is understand the process. Understand the process. There are processes that are set out by the Zimbabwe Investment Authority that guide how companies should move from the stage of looking at an initial project up until actually investing within that project. The Ministry of Mines as well is also very clear in terms of the types of licenses that you should gain as you move through from exploration all the way up to mine closure. So the most important thing is understand the process and use the process as a reference point. Because the temptation with these sorts of geographies is to create, especially with brokers in between, an environment where it seems unnavigable and only one person can help you navigate that. And that sort of practice can be mitigated against if you're continuing to go back to the process and saying, right, it says I should start here, what's happening at this stage? I'm now supposed to be at stage two, what's happening at this stage? Because for everything that's happening within the country, Zimbabwe's bureaucracy continues to be extremely effective in terms of following the process. So even if you might want to take shortcuts, you might end up getting there, but the time will come when you're sent back to square one and you're told to walk go through the motions.
Rishon, thank you so much for sharing your insights with us today.
Thank you.
Look forward to chatting to you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.